Hello and welcome to Love Talk. Now, many people, when they go into a new relationship, they carry with them baggage from what happened to them in the past. Mm-hmm. Now, what happens when that baggage gets too heavy for you to carry?
Well, everyone has their own, okay? This, mm-hmm. this is important to know, to understand. What happens, it depends on what they are carrying with them mm-hmm. that makes it heavy. Mm-hmm. Not all of them are heavy.
And of course, tonight we'll be talking about this and we'll be showing you an example in just a few moments. And we'll also have a couple who've been together, married for 18 years. Mm-hmm. And they'll be telling us the secret to making that relationship work. Also, we'll be listening in just a few moments from the people in London and what they have to say about this subject. But first, we want you to pay very close attention to this very short video, but that we'll explain a little bit, we'll explain in a few moments why we wanted to show you this video. Have a look.
From a young age, Kyle realized the pinups, which were exciting his friends, weren't catching his eye.
The first time I realized I was into older women, I probably was 12 or 13 years old. It's funny, the things that they're self-conscious about is what I'm into. I like lines, I like the neck feature. You know, women worry about their boobs sagging. I think the natural hang looks great. I'm a fan of platinum hair. I mean, I don't like to say gray, I like to say platinum. I'm a fan of platinum hair.
Most controversial is Kyle's long-term relationship with 91-year-old great-grandmother Marjorie McCall, who he met in 2009.
He came in where I worked to buy something and obtained my phone number, gave me his, and then every day he talked to me on the phone until we finally went out. It makes you feel wonderful, dating somebody younger than you. Makes you feel like you're alive again. The physical side of a relationship is wonderful. I amaze myself, he amazes me, and I like it.
When he first contacted me, I did question his motives because I was twice his age.
I have encountered people sometimes that are critical of what I do. But I mean, the most common is I'm a vulture. You're after money, you're after inheritance. I hear that all the time, it's not true at all. I do this because I like it and they like it too.
And his mum, Cecilia, fully supports his romantic choices, though admits it took some getting used to.
First time Kylie brought home a girlfriend, let's see, he was 22 and she was 50.
Yeah, so oh my God.
Yeah, you was a young woman back then.
Yeah, I know. I still feel like I am.
I've asked Kylie why he prefers older women, and he told me because the older women are, they're more mature. You know, there's somebody he can actually sit down and talk to. That's his lifestyle, that's what he likes, and he's not hurting anybody. I don't think that it's really anybody's business.
However, not everyone is convinced.
I couldn't imagine guys my age finding women that age attractive. I mean, he is, so to each their own. I mean, I respect that 100%.
At 91, dating a 31-year-old, that's pretty speechless. It's pretty weird.
But for Kyle, his romantic liaisons with senior citizens also present them with benefits too.
I offer older women a different experience than they normally used to. As opposed to them dating some tired old dead guy who's going to treat them the way that men treated women a long time ago, I offer them adventure. I show them things that are fun to do.
Right, so I'm sure you'll agree that what you saw there, it's not quite normal. Now, without wanting to pass judgment, the thing is that I'm sure every 31-year-old man or woman wouldn't really want to date someone who's 91 or 92, whatever old that age that lady was, never mind more than one of them.
Yeah,
right?
I was going to say that. This is a very typical example of someone carrying a very heavy baggage.
Right.
Very heavy baggage indeed.
And maybe you say, James, how do you know that this guy is carrying baggage? Well, we don't. But, you know, we can see by people's attitudes and how they behave,
we
can draw a conclusion, right?
Yeah, definitely. The way you behave in a relationship or in anything else mm-hmm. kind of shows what's inside of you, the way you think, the way you were brought up, all of these things, that one little mm-hmm. something inside your baggage. Yeah.
So we don't want to be psychotherapists here and say, oh, maybe he was hurt as a child or in a previous relationship. We're not saying that, but there is a reason why this person is not seeking a normal relationship. Mm-hmm. And this relationship is abnormal in two ways. First of all, because the people he's dating are more than twice his age. Mm-hmm. And secondly, because he wants a relationship that is, you know, with different people. And if you don't want to commit to someone, mm-hmm. there's a reason for that. There's a baggage for that.
There are many issues there. Mm-hmm. Many, many issues. Of course, we don't want to go into this too much. Because if they are happy, well, we wish them all the happiness, but they have issues there happening.
The thing is, I doubt that they are happy, right? Now, we went to the streets of London to ask people what they had to say about this issue of baggage in the relationship and how it affects relationships. Have a look.
Do you let your previous experience from the relationships affect your current or future relationships?
It does. I think as it does to everyone. You know, your previous relationship, you know, kind of paves the way for your future relationship as it is in life.
Currently, I'd say yes. Just because previous experiences kind of lay in your head and certain things remind you of your experiences and you kind of act upon what you've experienced previously. Sometimes you try and change it around, but it doesn't kind of work for you.
I think you learn from every relationship, but it never has to be a problem because every person is completely different to the one before or after. So, no, I think it doesn't matter, really.
Well, it doesn't. Luckily, I found a good guy now. But when I broke up with my ex, he treated me quite bad. He cheated on me, etc. So I found it hard to trust anyone for a really long time. So, like, it took me like 3 years to get into another relationship because he treated me so bad. So I would say it affects. But now I found someone good, so I do trust him.
A previous relationship probably did bear quite badly for the following relationship in that you kind of have expectations for people, and when they don't fulfill them, you're set up for disappointment. And then once that happens, you expect everyone to be the same and you expect everyone to kind of screw you over. I think it's very easy to kind of think that it's all going to be the same. And also, if the other person knows about your past, it makes it even harder, I think, because they kind of expect you to be the same as you were in that relationship. And I think all relationships change you as a person. And they teach you what you want out of your relationship. And if you don't get that, it's a lot easier to kind of shut it down and not let it grow.
Anything that happens to you in the past is always going to be carried on to your future, affect your decision making, affect your trust in people, and affect how you react to certain situations.
So a bit of a mixture there. I mean, we had people who said, you know, my previous relationships don't really affect my new ones, but someone said because of unfaithfulness, I think even abuse, that this person feels that this is still affecting her. Mm-hmm. And this is a real danger, Lena, is when people carry with them the hurt of the past and they start projecting that hurt onto the people that they are in, or the person mm-hmm. that they are in a relationship with. And sometimes they can end up setting themselves for failure.
It's true, but you know, the problem is that many people do not realize that they have that problem. Mm-hmm. And that is a problem in itself. Not realizing that you have the problem, how can you actually, you know, do something to, you know, to help yourself? Mm-hmm. You don't know. So maybe through this program today, we will be able to help, some of you who may think, well, I don't have a problem, but maybe you see that there's a pattern happening. There's something happening with your relationships, or maybe at work or with your, you know, finances or any other area of your life.
Yeah.
And there you go. Maybe you should look into this a bit more.
Now, the thing about baggage and the things you carry from your past is this. It's just that the fact that someone may have hurt you a certain way before, it doesn't mean that the person you're with now will hurt you again in the same way. And it would actually be unfair of you to think that this person would do this, because then you're not giving them a chance. So you need to be very careful that if you are carrying these things with you, if you're projecting them onto the person that you're with, like we said, you can be setting this relationship up for failure before you even try, before you even give it a chance. But also, you're being unfair. You're trying to put that person on the same level as the one who hurt you before. And who knows? Maybe this relationship would have really worked if you gave it a chance, but because of your heavy baggage, you didn't. So maybe it's time to move on.
Yeah, indeed. And I would even say, add to what you said, but to those, again, who don't know, or they are hearing this for the first time, for them it's something new, it's a good thing that maybe you can sit down sometime and write down a few points and analyze why, where do you keep on failing, and ask yourself why. You know, if we're talking about relationships here, okay, but it could be in any area. But if it's in a relationship, why? Why are you always, why do you always go through this or that? Why? And you, chances are that looking back, you will see that there are some roots there that make you behave that way.
Absolutely. Now, we're going to go and see the quiz that we did with the couple that are our guests here today. You'll see how they did, how well they know each other. It was quite interesting. And also, when we come back, I want to give you an example of how you can not only deal with the baggage you have, but also get rid of any unwanted excess baggage. We'll be right back. Welcome back. Now, it's always interesting to see how couples know each other, especially if it's two people that have been together for 18 years. We hope that they would have gotten all their questions right.
But some of them were not easy, okay?
Yeah.
I don't know if you would have gotten all right about me.
I don't think probably I would. But that's what we have the quiz for.
Anyway,
and that's why
fun.
The quiz is not for us. It's for our guests. So we hope you enjoy it.
Welcome to Love Talk Quiz. How well do you really know your partner? Well, today we will check how well Roy and Andrea really know each other. Are you ready, guys?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so let's begin. Ladies first, of course. So first question for you, Andrea. What's the one thing, apart from your partner, of course, that you would save in a fire? Time starts now.
Pictures.
Well done. Okay, so we are ready for the second one. All right, let's go. How many times did your partner take his driving test?
Once.
Okay, we don't even need a timer here.
Yes.
Okay then, so question number three, well done. What's the first movie you ever saw together? Time starts now.
Titanic.
No. Time's out, sorry. The correct answer is Volcano.
Yes.
Remember?
Yes.
Okay, question number four. Are you ready?
Yes.
What's your partner's favorite time of the year? Time starts now.
Summer?
No.
Spring.
Exactly. All right then, one more go. What's his favorite food? Now think very well. What's his favorite food?
Pasta and shrimps.
Well done! Okay, let's see how well Roy knows Andrea, because she got almost all the answers right. Anyway, are you ready, Roy?
Yes.
Yeah, are you sure?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. What is her favorite flower? Time starts now.
Favorite flower?
Yes.
Roses?
No. Time is running out. Yeah, sorry. It's actually orchids.
Complicated.
Yeah. But anyway, we understand you are a man. But let's go. You still have a few more questions, okay? Are you ready for the next one?
Yes.
All right. What's her favorite holiday destination? Where would she like to go?
Maybe like to a beach in Hawaii, for example.
Oh my God. Yeah, that's correct. Well done, well done. Okay. So you still have a few more to redeem yourself, huh? Okay, third question. What's a favorite item of clothing? Time starts now.
Like a shirt, trousers.
No.
Blazer.
Yes, just in time. Well done. So question number four, ready?
Yes.
What's a favorite book? Time starts now. Think very well.
Favorite book?
Yes.
Better than a pair of shoes.
Not that one. Time's run out. And the correct answer is Redeeming Love by Francine Rivers. Okay? You still have one last question. Are you ready for this one?
Yes.
Okay. What's her guilty pleasure? Time starts now.
Chocolate.
Oh, there you go. Well done, actually. Roy, you did very well. Anyway, guys, back to the studio now.
Well, I hope you enjoyed that. It was quite funny. Now, I want to give an example to our viewers at home of how bad baggage in previous relationships can be, but also how you can overcome.
And make the most of it as well, isn't
yes.
it?
Yes. And you know, Elena, it's just like going on a plane. When you have excess weight in your baggage, it's very expensive.
You pay the price.
You pay the price. Very, very expensive to carry excess weight in the baggage.
And sometimes you're not allowed to take your baggage with you.
That's right. Sometimes you have to leave it behind. I've seen a lot of people in airports opening their suitcases and getting stuff out, right? I want to give you an example. I have here this bag. It's not heavy. I'm just pretending that.
He's such a good actor, isn't he?
Now, imagine you have here on this bag all the bad stuff you've accumulated from previous relationships, right? So you have here perhaps the betrayal, perhaps the lack of trust, the lack of respect, you know, maybe abusive words. Now, this is your life. This is you. Now, I can choose to carry in this bag, Elena, whatever I want.
Yeah.
I can open up this bag and I can remove what I don't want there anymore. Or I can keep it here.
Absolutely. One thing you can't do is to get rid of the bag.
Yeah.
Because we all have a bag.
Absolutely. Now, the thing is, if I carry too much weight on this bag, it's my choice, right? I can say, look, I don't want to carry this weight. I want to get rid of it. And I can do that. And relationships are very much like this, right? I mean, you cannot choose the stuff that has happened to you in the past. If something has happened to you, then it's there. But you can keep it as an experience, which doesn't really have any weight, or you can keep it as something that haunts you, and that's not healthy.
Absolutely. You know, you have to make you have to make the most of what you have. But something I just wanted to say is that this kind of thing, this heaviness that you carry around with you, okay, it accumulated because, you know, throughout your life, throughout your adult life, maybe, you know, relationships that you've had, like James just said, but most of it came from your upbringing, from well back. So it's like a chain.
Absolutely.
And if you don't break that chain, there will be a time where the chain is going to be, you know, too short. Does that make sense? It's going to tie you around and around you, and you can't move anymore because, I mean, this is you. I mean, this is the heaviness you carry around with you.
Yeah.
And there's things that you can do with it. So most of it is to throw it away. And how can, maybe they will ask at home, but how can I do that? I mean, there's many ways you can get rid of that heaviness. It's by acknowledging, like we spoke in the beginning, but also talking about it.
Yeah.
With someone, if you have a partner, speaking about it with your partner.
And sometimes it starts with a decision. Like anything in life, if you think about it, everything in your life that you've decided to do, that you've done, it started with a decision. If you're watching me now and you're an immigrant in this country, from my accent you probably have noticed that I am myself, then you came here because one day you made a decision to come here and fight for a better life. If you changed your career, it all started with a decision. You said one day, I don't want to do this job anymore. I want to do something different. And that decision changed the course of your life. Mm-hmm. Now, with your baggage, it's very much like this. You can talk about it, like you were saying, opening up about your baggage is very important. But if you talk about it and you don't make a decision mm-hmm. to not let that rule your life, mm-hmm. then you can talk about it to 100
yeah,
people,
definitely.
It will still control you.
Yeah, definitely. When we say you should talk about it, it's because, like you mentioned in mm-hmm. the beginning of the program, the other person may not understand you. It's like, mm-hmm. why does he behave this way? Why is he so stingy? Why is he so jealous? Why is he so, I don't know, you name it, or, you know, because of these things. So it's going to help the other person be patient with you.
Absolutely.
If you are receptive as well, if you also choose to be helped,
yeah,
you know.
So it is important for you to talk to the person that you're in a relationship with, make them understand why perhaps you've been behaving a certain way. Maybe you don't really talk about your problems, because in a previous relationship, you spoke about a problem that you had and that person took advantage of you, made the most of knowing your weaknesses and hurt you. Mm-hmm. So maybe you should explain that to the person you're with. Mm-hmm. The bottom line comes to a decision, to saying, I will not be a slave to whatever happened to me in the past anymore. Now, maybe you say, James, this is easier said than done. It's very easy to say, very difficult to do.
We've had to do that ourselves. Mm-hmm. I mean, we are so different from one another, different upbringings. I mean, it is something that it's very much doable.
Yeah. But it is difficult. And if you say, James, it's easier said than done, I actually agree with you. And I know it's hard, it's difficult. But think about all the benefits you will have from deciding not to carry this heavy load with you anymore. Mm-hmm. Think about the benefits of taking this weight that has dragged you down, that has dragged your current relationship down, and getting rid of this. You'll be all the better for it.
And you know what I wanted just to add? One thing. You know, people nowadays, and I don't want to sound like, oh, I'm so perfect, because it's not about that. It's that many people, they skip certain important steps mm-hmm. in life. For example, talking about relationships, of course, they skip the dating period. So the dating period is first to get to know the other person, for you to get to know what is he made of, where did he come from, why is he like this, or he likes the countryside, I like the city, why does he like the countryside? Because all these things will give you clues for the future if you decide to stay with the person. Mm-hmm. Don't you agree?
Absolutely.
I mean, we got to know each other, we knew everything about each other. Mm-hmm. And that really helped us overcome our differences.
Yeah, we knew as much as we could know in that
yeah,
period.
Yeah, but we did our homework.
Absolutely.
And that's important.
So here's our tip, our top tip for you. If mm-hmm. you really want to overcome the excess baggage you've carried, then it all starts with a decision. Talk about it with your partner and say, I don't want to carry this anymore, and move on. Choose to start again. Absolutely. We're going to go into a break. When we come back, we're going to hear a brief interview with our couple, and straight away, we'll delve into their story and we'll hear how their relationship, their journey has begun and where it is today. We'll be right back. Welcome back. So we have our guests here, Roy and Andrea. How are you guys?
Very well.
Good.
Yes. And well done. And the quiz went really well. I mean, out of five, you had three correct answers.
Yes, correct.
And you had four answers.
So congratulations. Surprising. You won, Andrea. Yeah. We haven't got a trophy.
Indeed.
Maybe that's something for the future. We need to get a few trophies here. Okay. Now, you guys have been married for how long?
18 years. So on this falling month of September, so on September, will be 18 years
that we are married. Years. That's a long time. And I knew you when you were single,
yes.
right? Now, what's the secret? What's the secret for you, for a couple to last 18 years, to be happy for 18 years? What would you say the secret is?
So the secrets, there are many secrets, of course. And so we have to sacrifice for each other. And also good communication. Mm-hmm. And also faith. Faith also helps to keep the marriage to last until mm-hmm. the end.
Well, if it works for you, well done.
Absolutely.
Yeah, indeed.
Now, when you first got together, when you first got married, did you have any clashes of personality, problems in the beginning?
We were very different. Mm-hmm. We had to learn how to live with this difference, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because like one likes fish, the other one likes meat, things like that.
We are completely different.
Wow. Completely different.
But you guys, you know, those differences kind of attracted one to another, right?
For example, she talks more than me. I'm very quiet.
Mm-hmm.
And something that I liked in her was that she talks a lot. And because I'm very quiet, so...
So you liked the fact that she was more talkative?
Yes.
Interesting.
Most men don't.
And of course, this in the beginning was very good because she talks a lot. I really enjoyed. But in the beginning of our marriage, so also brought problems because sometimes I want her to be more quiet, more silence.
All right, then it was too good to be true. I have to admit.
Now, you in these 18 years that you've been married, what is the greatest challenge that you ever faced in your marriage? The greatest, most difficult thing you had to overcome in all this time?
So, always there are new challenges. For example, in the work that we do, sometimes we move from city to city, from country to country, and sometimes we face problems, difficulties. Like in all kinds of situations, like to adapt to the culture of the country sometimes. For example, I remember that once we went to a country and for example, my son, he had to make an operation. Mm-hmm. So it was a very hard moment because we hadn't no friends around because we were alone, working a place alone. And we had no family members around to help us. So it was very hard at that time.
But would you say that in moments like that, where you don't have anyone and you have to rely on each other, do you end up getting closer to one another because you don't have anyone else?
Yes, for sure. We are closer in this kind of moments that there's nobody else, so we have to be friends to each other. We have to support each other.
Mm-hmm.
So these difficulties sometimes bring us even together, more than normal.
But tell me something, when you can't agree on something, how do you deal with that? For example, you want something, she doesn't want that same thing. How do you deal with this kind of thing?
So, normally, easily, we come to an agreement. We don't too long to discuss, so easily we come in agreement.
But how, like Elena said, how do you reach that agreement?
Because it sounds very good, but people who are watching us, maybe they're like, I can't just agree with my partner on anything. It's really hard. So how do you do it?
One always have to
give in.
Yeah, give in. Mm. Usually I think it's me. But
it's true. It's true. Yes. You agree.
Yeah. So, yeah, because if no one does that part, so it's going to be a clash. So, okay, so I see what he wants and I can give it a chance. So I...
Does he do it for you as well? Do you do the same for her as well?
Yes, yes. But she does more for me. You know, to be honest, she's more patient with me than sometimes I am with her. Mm. She's very patient. With me, with my son, she's someone.
Well, you have to be, isn't it? Once you have children.
Now,
it's like...
when we did the interview with them earlier, I found out that you were in a band, Roy.
Yes.
What did you do in the band?
So I belong to.
Were
a
you
band.
Were you the band manager?
No, I was the drummer.
So you were the drummer.
Yes.
Okay.
So we used to go to play in pubs, in bars, in nightclubs, in places like that. So, but then when I knew her, so my mind changed. So then I
So the fact that he was in a band, did that attract you to him?
Tell the truth.
At the beginning, I didn't know. Mm-hmm. So it was not the main point. For me, was this dedication, you know, the way that he invests in his life. I know that at least he wants something for his life. So that was what attracted me, not the point of the band by itself, but the dedication and because he wants to do something in life, so that attracts me.
And you know, she was talking about dedication. Roy mentioned that when he first met her, to impress her, he went and borrowed a car from a friend,
yes,
so he could drive her home. Well, right? That's how determined he was.
Did that story end nicely, or did you crush the car or something?
No, I don't think so.
Nice.
So, it was like the moment. The moment was asking that, so I Aww. Did something crazy, and I went
off. Paid off because you married her, right?
Yes. Exactly.
That's great.
It was all or nothing at that
Good.
Moment.
Now, I mean, what do you admire most about Andrea? And Andrea, what do you admire most about Roy?
So it's like I said before, I admire her because she's very sincere. So she is what she is. If she's okay, she's okay. If she's upset with something, so she shows that she's upset with something. And in everything that she does, she's very dedicated. And always when you face a problem, always she finds a way to find out a solution and to solve the problem. So we never, like, I never saw her leaving like a situation and live there. No, always she found a solution to mm-hmm. solve that problem and not to leave that problem there.
Wow, Andre, do you realize what this means?
Yes.
Had he ever told you that before?
He's a great yes. admirer oh, of great. Yours.
What about well you, Andre? What do you admire about him?
Oh, what I admire in my husband is his character, mm-hmm. because I know that I can trust him. For him, there's no big lies or small lies. You know, he's that kind of person that I feel the confidence to be next to him, because I know that for him, he doesn't hide anything from me. Mm-hmm. He shows everything, and I know that I can trust him. Mm-hmm. And this is the thing that I really appreciate in him.
Wow, very nice as well, huh? Men out there, that's a good one.
That's a lesson.
Can I ask the next question? Because I'm really curious.
We have to go to a break. We only have a few seconds, but I promise
after,
you...
After the break,
I
then.
Promise you the next question. And actually, we're going to find out from them. After 18 years of marriage, how they keep their relationship fresh and new and romantic, and they keep things working the way they've been working for the past 18 years. So don't go anywhere. Welcome back. Now, I promised you, Elena, that you could ask the next question, so you have the floor. Go ahead.
Right. I want to ask you something. I know you have a very busy lifestyle, that you move around quite a lot. How do you, because of work, of course, but how do you manage to have quality time with your family? Because I know you have a son. How do you cope with everything that you do, plus family time? How does that work?
We try to do everything together. Mm-hmm. For example, if we go for a walk, the three of us go. We speak in that walk. We take advantage at those moments to be closer to each other and speak and, you know, have communication between us. And take advantage of any small time
that you have available.
Yes, like for example, if we are at home and we are watching TV, we're going to choose a program that everybody likes to watch.
So you don't have a TV in every compartment?
Every room.
Thank you. Every room of the house?
No.
And everyone goes and watches their own thing?
No. We just have one TV and we have to agree, the three of us, to watch something.
Absolutely. Now, the question we mentioned before the break was, after 18 years of being married, how do you keep things exciting? How do you keep the relationship fresh? What do you do?
For example, we used to like to act with each other as we were boyfriends and girlfriends. And also, you know, with the little things and simple things, sometimes we make the difference. Like a joke, like to go out. You know, we don't need like big things or luxury, for example, mm-hmm. to make a relationship to work. Sometimes the small things, the simple things, mm-hmm. makes the whole difference. And we try to be the best friends possible. So before we are like husband and wife, we are friends.
Mm-hmm. That is very nice, you see.
What about from your side, Andrea?
From my side, I know everything that I need to do at home, like cooking and everything, but I try to, when my husband comes home to be smelling nice, looking nice for him, because I think that is important in a marriage, because when they know us in the beginning, they look at us always looking nice, but sometimes when people get married, they forgot about this.
They let themselves go a bit, isn't it?
Yeah, so it's one of the things that when he arrives at home at night, I try to be, you know, smelling nice, be clean
to
for
welcome him.
Yeah.
And you know, they were talking about, Roy was talking about the little things. And nowadays, even with things like text message and things like this, you know, I know you're very busy at work, but you can send a message to each other, and that sometimes makes the person's day, right?
Of course.
I do that to you sometimes.
Even a call, sometimes
a call.
Yeah, he
yes, how are you?
Yeah. And, but you do that, I think
no,
you do
no.
more than me.
In regards to calls, he calls me to complain that I didn't pick up the phone, but he does
yes.
that to me often.
Yes, although you have improved a lot.
Oh, thank you. That means so much to me.
Okay, guys.
Yeah, little things is what matters indeed.
Now, I mean, I think I want to leave a specific question here for the end, but something I wanted to ask you is, I mean, how is your relationship now compared to how it was in the beginning? I mean, is it better? Do you love each other more? Are things even better than what they were in the beginning?
It's better. You know why? Because I was remembered before to come to the program, I was remembered that a few years ago, we were in a country, and then she went to Portugal, back to Portugal, to visit our family. And I was 1 week alone.
Oh.
And I never missed her so much.
Did you have your son with you at that time?
Yes.
Was he born?
Yes. So I was 1 week alone because she went to visit our family. And for me, it was the worst week ever because I miss her a lot. So as the years are passing by, I think that we are depending on each other. So every year we depend more on each other. Mm-hmm.
I'm going to let you ask the last question, Lena.
Right. What is that thing that you have tried, but you've never actually managed to change about one another? Like, for example, what is it about Roy that you've tried to change? Like, oh, he's a very nice person, but he's got this little annoying habit about himself.
And you've given up. You don't even try anymore. Yeah.
And you will also have your chance.
There is a thing in his personality that I think most men have, but he has that. Sometimes he likes to be like in his own world, just resting his mind,
You mean, let me translate this, okay?
I know that feeling, I know that.
Is it quietness?
Yes.
Like just not speaking?
The sofa there, quiet. And sometimes in the beginning that bothers me, but I saw that with the time I could not change, even if I ask, what are you thinking about?
Yes. that's a big problem for us in the beginning.
It's because the men, we have a box called nothing.
Yes.
So
oh
I'm
my
there
God,
to play.
Listen, I envy you men so much because I wish I had that box. Because sometimes you will agree with me and Andrea, it's like you want to switch off, but you can't because you have many things going on in your mind and things that you have to remember and do. And sometimes it's just like, I don't know, I have no words.
Yeah.
But we had that exact same thing. So we know what you guys went through. What about you, Roy? What have you given up trying to change about Andrea?
For example, sometimes like things in the work, for example, if you have to explain about this program in the computer or in the iPhone, and all that, I have to repeat the same thing, so I give up. Okay, do as you know.
Yeah.
Because always I'm there. It's true or not, I'm there.
Yeah, and you know, Roy, it's the same thing here. I've told Elena that just the fact that you click the red cross on the program and the window closes, it doesn't mean the program is closed. And then she has like 10 open programs and she says, look, James, why is my computer so slow? And then I say, because you have to switch off the programs. I've done that about 100 times, but it didn't work, so I give up as well.
It's like the email is always open, everything closed,
yes.
Switch off.
We understand each other.
It's because women, we are more practical. We have other things to worry about.
Of course, of course.
Many things, and we don't have children. You have a child and you know what I'm talking about. Mm. It's many things. So for us, leave the program running, the battery dying.
but these are not...
Like leave the computer all night long, then on.
Weeks long.
Switch off the computer. Yeah. Forget about leave then.
But you know, the good thing is that these are little things that actually make that person even more special for you, right? Mm. And it's really good to hear your story. We wanted to thank you guys for being here.
Indeed.
And your relationship is an example, because after 18 years of being together, that shows... You guys got married when you were very young, right?
Yes, I was 21 and she was 19.
Yeah, so same thing like us. Yes. And I mean, you prove that a relationship has stumbling blocks, but it can work. So thank you very much for being on the show.
Thank you for your tips. It's really, really nice. Thank you.
And we wanted to take this last few minutes of the program to let you know that if you've had relationships prior to the one that you're on, then of course there is a certain baggage that you carry with you. But there's two kinds of baggage. There's the baggage of something you carry with you that stops you from making the most of your current relationship. And then there's the baggage of experience. Mm-hmm. You have learned from a certain experience. You don't let that control you, but you allow that not to make you make the same mistakes again.
Absolutely. You always learn from your mistakes. And you know, it's inevitable. You do carry things around with you. Mm-hmm. But my kind of tip for today would be, whatever is there in your little bag that you don't need, just throw it away. Mm-hmm. Because it's not going to help you. It's going to weigh you down. It's going to make you behave in a way that you don't like, that you're going to be like, why did I do this? Why did I treat this person that way? If you really think deep, you will see that this is due to your baggage. Mm-hmm. Baggage, right?
Yes.
I was going to say luggage.
Very similar. Luggage, baggage.
I don't know how heavy it is. But you understand? So it's very important. Get rid of everything that is not good for you.
Yeah. And I mean, you can't change things that you've been through, mistakes that you've made, or things that were done to you, right? Mm-hmm. What you can do, I mean, in our past is very good for one thing, and that is for us to keep not a very big bag full of baggage, or things you don't want to carry around, but certainly things you've learned, experiences. And then you make sure that you don't trip on the same stumbling blocks you had in your past. So as long as you can do that, as long as you can learn from your past and mistakes that happened, I'm sure that you will go into a new relationship, or that relationship you're in right now can be a lot better, because you can prevent yourself from making the same mistakes. Okay? It's been a pleasure to be with you. Until next time, have a wonderful afternoon.